So before we start the nucleus removal, we need to understand the foot pedal, which is very important. It has got a central part which goes like this. When you put into irrigation aspiration mode, there are only these two modes are there. When there's a FACO mode, this last is when it reaches at this point, you start doing the FACO emulsification. So why it is important to have a foot control? Because when you are doing the vacuum seal, when you are trying to hold the nucleus, first you got to bury it, go in this mode, and then bring it back over here so that you can hold it. If you keep on delivering the energy, you will lose the grip. So it's very important to have a foot control, how to go to mode 3 and come back to 2, so that you can hold on to the nucleus. So this you should learn even before you start doing any human eye. Just sit down and just feel it, how it feels in your foot. And then there are certain side kicks, very important to know where the reflex kick is, so that suddenly if you catch unwanted material, you are looking for how to release it. So you should mentally feed yourself the left hand side, right hand side, where the reflex is. This is very important to have a tactile feedback as well as auditory feedback, because in a different mode, the machine may be giving you different sounds. When it goes into the FACO mode, it may be tuck, 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 voice is coming. And when it is on aspiration mode only, there may be just one another sound. So that you know that when you have gone into which mode. So tactile as well as auditory feedback is very important to know. And then we need to reduce the energy while doing FACO emulsification. When you are doing a trenching, many of them just go into the position 3 and remain there while they are having a backstroke when you are coming back and not emulsifying. So you make an effort when you are going in, cutting it, FACO is on. When you are coming back, FACO is off. When you are going in, FACO is on. When you are coming back, FACO is off. And again, as I told you, when you are chopping, you got to go into the FACO mode and then come into the aspiration mode. And when you are doing a FACO aspiration, you hold a nucleus, give a little bit of energy, it gets sucked in, then hold it again, then give a little bit of energy. So the FACO on and off keeps on going when you already chopped and you are sucking it. So this is very important so that you can reduce your effective FACO time to use all these methods so that you don't cause a corneal burn or any other issues. And all the FACO emulsification has to be performed in this central safe zone, because the cornea is maximum convex over here, capsule is most maximum concave over here. No FACO should be performed in the FACO peripheral zone, which is very, very unsafe. You try to do FACO over here, you may have a PCR. So that means you need to hold the nucleus, bring it to the center and emulsify there. So do not try to consume the nucleus into the periphery. Whatever method of chopping and dismantling you might be doing. And when we do the FACO emulsification, we need to understand the anatomy of the nucleus, which is far more convex over here. So when you are making a trench, if you make a trench like this, this will not crack. So your trench has to be deep in the center, because the nucleus is like that. And whenever, whatever way we use the removal of the nucleus, there are certain aspects of the nucleus removal. That means you need to make some amount of trench, then you need to split into two, then you have got to chop it, and then you have got to aspirate it. So whatever, whether it's a divide and conquer, a stop and chop, direct chop, whatever method it may be, so these are the following steps you need to master. So when we are doing a trenching, it is can be done better with the 45 degree, but 30 degree is a universal tip. And particularly for a hard nucleus, Kelman tip is very good. For myopes, Kelman tip is very good, because if it's a bent angle, you can go to the depth far more easily. So trenching is done very well with the Kelman tip. Whenever you are doing a trenching, there should be enough of energy. That means if your FACO power is less and you are pushing the nucleus, it's no good. But your FACO power is too much, you are delivering there, you see the small air bubble forming over there. So your cutting speed and movement of the FACO are such in a way coordinated that all the energy is emulsifying, no energy is wasted over there. You can put into the continuous mode, or you can go into the high pulse mode, high pulse rate, which acts as a virtually continuous mode. Depth should always be deep in the center, not in the periphery. So as I told you, according to the anatomy of the eye. If the width is, if it is a harder cataract, you should make it a little wider so that your sleeve can be accommodated and you can go into the depth of the nucleus. Then we come to the very important part, what we call as a vacuum seal. That means when you are trying to remove the nucleus, whether by the direct chop or any other method, you first nudge the central part of the nucleus. Most of the time we hold on to the superior part. We are too scared of the posterior capsule, but superior superficial part will not hold it so well. So into the central part of the nucleus, give a burst of energy, bury it over there, and then come to the mode 2 and hold it and then chop it. This is called vacuum seal, when you bury it and hold the nucleus. And then you can, of course, perform the central chop, peripheral chop, or modified chop. And a peripheral chop is when you start chopping from the periphery of the nucleus. This maneuver is a little difficult because you've got to negotiate your chopper underneath the rectus margin, go to the periphery, create a vacuum seal, pull towards the center, and move the sideways. While we call it central chop, when you chop within the rectus margin, you bury it straight down and separate it. We'll talk more about it as we go on to the chopping. And the modified chop is a peripheral chop where the periphery has been brought out of the rectus margin. Thank you.